Good morning, YouTube and Facebook. This is Alan from Spotless Carpet Cleaning. I'm out on another beautiful and amazing day. Yes, it is. God is good. God is good. I will always say that. So I'm out in Somerset this morning to do a job for a first-time customer. And it's nice when you can get jobs in your community close by instead of going out a long way. There's nothing wrong going out a couple miles to get jobs, but it just feels good when you can be around your community and around your neighbor and, you know, find jobs, you know, something is working right there. So let me take you in and let me show you what is it I'm working on this morning.
Okay, so we are inside the house. You can see what's on the carpet. And you know what that is. So my customer, they just got a puppy and it's not been trained as yet. So you know, when you first get a puppy, what happens when they get excited when they see people. So he's been in this room most of the time and he's been doing his little business on the carpet. As you can see, there's just topical spots. And I'm here to put some extra love back into this for my customer. Get these spots out as good as possible and have the room smelling nice and fresh. So it's this room, as I said, and we have another one which do not have that much. It's just one, two here. Yeah, this one is in good condition. So that's the main one that have all the pet stain. So you know what's the first step. Don't have to say it, right? But I will say it. Vacuum, getting as much dry soil out of this carpet before I put down the pre-spray. The pet treatment first, because we have a lot of pet stain, letting it dwell, come back and doing the others. So it's that time to start the vacuuming. As you see, I have it right here.
Thank you.
worn out battery from the fiber. I had something, chair was here, kind of the table here. So the back and forth on the wheel, put up the fiber of the carpet. Eventually, get to the other one and get back to you. Alright, guys? Okay, so we just finished vacuuming the two rooms. I'll show you what I get out of the two rooms when I'm finished with this job. So right now I'll be treating these pet stain. I'm using Unchain from Rob Allen from TMF. So I'll be putting this down, treating the spots, letting it dwell, and come back and put in on the normal pre-spray. You don't want to wet, put too much down, because you oversaturate it and then it goes into the backing. And that's how you get wicking coming up. Then you come back with the pre-spray, then you put it down again, and then if you don't do a good extraction, all of that stuff just sits in the backing of the carpet. And then when it's humid, you get that coming back up to the surface. Okay, so let me finish treating these and I'll come back and show you how they are disappearing. Okay, guys, so I have the chemistry upstairs dwelling on the carpet. It's going to need a good dwell time because of all that pet stain that was there. So I'm going to be dumping my canister to show you what I get out of those two rooms. And most of this came out of the first room that have all the pet stains, seeing that the dog is always in that room instead of the other one. So you'll find more pet hair, pet dander coming from that one room. So you can see here, dry soil, and just other stuff that was in the carpet. Okay, so I had the chemistry down a while, just doing what it's supposed to do, dwell time, breaking down the pet stains on the carpet, and you can see how much better it's looking just by the chemistry and the carpet only. It's just eating up all of that pet stain, the urine stain that's on the carpet. I'm breaking it down. So now it's time to come back with the CRB, agitate this carpet and push the chemistry a bit further down into the fibers. Okay, guys, so here we go. Let me know how you love that CRB action. I have a new setup. I bought a tripod so I can put on my CRB so I don't have to be holding the phone in my hand. Let me know how you guys are loving it. It's the first time trying it out. And look at the room after CRBing. This was the room that had all the pet spots. And as I said, even though you vacuum, you're still gonna get stuff coming out the carpet, and that's what the CRB pulled out. But you can just see the big difference in good dwell time with the chemistry. Coming back and agitating the carpet, it's a must when you're dealing with pet stain, because you need to push that chemistry further down into the fiber, and you need that extra agitation to break down whatever is in the carpet. So let me set up now with the Wonder hose to do the extraction phase. Guys, let me finish up this and get to the other one. I'll come back and show you after we're done. We are over in the other room. And you see from before, this room is not as bad as the fourth one I just finished. Under the bed. Okay, so let me finish this one up and come back and show you everything. So I'm finished with this strap. I'm still wrapping up. As you can see, I still have my corner guards now, my flow protector. Corner guard is there. And this room came out amazing. This is the one that had the least pet stain. Came out very well. I have the windows open so we can have some cross-action air going through the house. Now this is the one that's going to blow everybody's mind. You remember this? Yes, came out gorgeous. As I said, good dwell time, good agitation, heat, extract, and just dry strokes. I also have these windows open so we can have air coming from all angles of the house, goes through the house, and that helps speed up the drying of the carpet. So if you guys love what you saw today, just go and, you know, hit the subscribe button, you know, drop a comment. And if you like or love the way I do the CRB today, just let me know in a post below. All right guys, I shall see you later. Enjoy the rest of your day.